Serbonika.
Zdravo svima, ja sam Magdalena, osnivač Serbonike i profesor srpskog jezika.
Hello everyone, I'm Magdalena, founder of Serbonika and a Serbian language teacher. Today I want to talk to you about the collective nouns and one subgroup of the collective nouns, and that's neuter gender collective nouns.
Zbirne imenice are collective nouns.
If you're using Serbonika, if you're learning with the second course, you've learned about voce and povrće. That means fruits and vegetables. Voce, fruits, povrće, vegetables. These nouns are special because they don't have plural. They mean a collection of things. Voce, povrće, they're both neuter gender singular, and they mean plural. They mean a set of things of similar kind, same type of things. So they change in singular. Voce je zdravo. Let's write an example. Voce je zdravo. Fruits are healthy, or the fruit in general is healthy. Voce je zdravo. I used je, singular form of verb to be, like is, je, zdravo, neuter singular form of this adjective healthy, zdrav. Voce je zdravo. Now, let's think an example about povrće. Deca ne vole povrće. Povrće je ukusno. Povrće je ukusno. Vegetables are tasty. Vegetables, povrće, singular, je, we use the verb in singular, is, ukusno, adjective in neuter gender form, singular, ukusno. Voće je zdravo, povrće je ukusno. Now, if you're following me, you've heard in the last video I talked about the forest, and I used some words that fit into this category. These words are drveće, cveće, lišće. Did you remember these words? Let's write them down. Drveće, trees. Cveće, flowers. Lišće, leaves. If you take a look, you will notice that all these nouns actually end in će. Voće, povrće, drveće, cveće, lišće. So this ending sometimes, not always, will sometimes reveal this type of a noun, which is collective, neuter gender singular, and means a collection of things, a set of similar things. Drveće je visoko. Drveće je visoko i veliko. I said something similar in the video. Also, I said drveće se njiše. Drveće se njiše. Se njiše. The verb is also in singular and it means the trees are swaying. Drveće se njiše. Cveće je šareno. Cveće je šareno. The flowers are multicolor. Cveće je šareno. Lišće je suvo. Leaves are dry. Lišće je suvo. Voće i povrće, they actually don't have a singular meaning word. Well, there is. For fruits, we have a word voćka. Voćka. This is a different word. It's not one form of the word voce. It's a different word and it means a fruit, either a fruit tree or a fruit like an apple is one voćka, or an apple tree, voćka. Povrće, we don't have a word like this for povrće, but sometimes jokingly we will say povrćka. It's a joking word. It's not a real word. On the other hand, the three words that I just added that talk about the woods, drveće, cveće, lišće, they have a normally, regularly used singular words. Drvo. Drvo is a special word that gets an infix in genitive and other cases. Drvo, drveta, tree of the tree. So it gets this et infix. Drvo, drveta. Does it remind you of another word, of another neuter gender word? It's very similar to dete, deteta, the child of the child. These are special neuter gender words with this infix et. Cveće also has a singular form word. Cvet, jedan cvet, one flower. Lišće, jedan list, one leaf or even one sheet of paper. Ovo je jedan list papira. Ovo je jedan list. Now, if I have several sheets of paper, can I say lišće for these several sheets of paper? No, never. I will never say lišće for these. These are listovi. Listovi papira. List, listovi. But if I take this plant, this little plant that I have in this vase, ovo je jedan list. Ovo je jedan mali list. Ova biljka ima tanko lišće. This plant has thin leaves. Ova biljka ima tanko lišće. Or I can also say tanke listove. Ova biljka ima tanke listove ili tanko lišće. Ova biljka ima tanke listove, thin leaves, ili tanko lišće. What happens with cvet? The same thing as list. We also have cvet, cvetovi. Cvet, cvetovi. Cvetovi is a normal plural from the word cvet. But we also have this cveće word that means flowers or even plants, house plants in general. So, ja volim cveće means I love plants or flowers. Cveće, sobno cveće. This is a room flower, we say, or room plant. Cveće. Ja volim cveće. So, in general, this kind of stuff, you know, that's cveće. Cvetovi is when I talk about blooms or blossoms, individual blossoms, but there's more of them. Drvo is a polysemic word. It means a lot of things. It can mean a tree or wood. Wood as a material. The closet is made of wood. So it can mean tree, trees, wood, and also the firewood. Firewood, like pieces of wood, chunks of wood for lighting a fire, building a fire. In these three circumstances, we will use different grammatical forms. So when it's tree, we will say drvo i drveće, lepo drveće u šumi, veliko drveće u šumi. But if I have firewood in front of my house, that will be drva, drva. Firewood are drva. That's plural. Jedno drvo i drva. Wood as a material, that you make something from it, is always used in singular. Drvo. Ovaj sto je od drveta. Let's write it down. Ovaj sto je od drveta. And for trees, we will use drveće. This collective noun, actually, we will use for trees. Drveće. Drvo, drveće. Drvo, drveće. All right, so these are all collective nouns. They are neuter gender and they are always used in the singular, voće, povrće, drveće, cveće, lišće. When we want to use these words in singular, we actually use a different word, voćka, povrćka, drvo, cvet, list. These are different words, actually, not different shapes of one word. That's why we have drvo, neuter gender singular, and it means singular. And we have drveće, neuter gender singular, and it means singular. Okay, so if you want to learn more Serbian with quizzes and exercises and all things that you need, please join Serbonika and learn with us. And in the end, try and write some sentences in the comments of this video. Use the words that you've just learned. Use them and write the sentence in the comments. Thank you and see you at Serbonika. Hvala vam i vidimo se na Serboniki. Serbonika.